Very good morning to all. In this lecture, we are going to cover next topic from unit number 3, that is cavity breakdown and electroconvection breakdown in case of liquid dielectric medium. So in the last lecture, we discussed the concept of suspended solid particle breakdown mechanism in case of liquid dielectric media. And finally, we conclude that as the number of solid particle present in a liquid dielectric media increases, their dielectric strength decreases. Now in this lecture, we are going to study the concept of cavity breakdown in case of liquid dielectric media. That means if a gas bubble, or you can say air cavity or water cavity, are present in a liquid dielectric media, then how their presence is going to affect their respective dielectric strength. So before we are going to start our exact topic, first of all, we are going to discuss what are the basic reasons for the formation of gas bubble in case of liquid dielectric media. So the first point is, due to the presence of gas pocket on the surface of electrode, it may be anode or it may be cathode. Second is, due to the irregularities of electrode surface, because of which what will happen, this leads to a formation of point charges, results into the formation of corona discharge. And once the corona discharge initiated, this leads to the formation, or you can say vaporization, of liquid. And as a result of this process, we are having a bubble of gases as an output in case of liquid dielectric medium. Third is, due to the change in temperature and pressure of liquid dielectric media, it is responsible for the formation of small cavity, or you can say air bubble, in a given dielectric medium. Fourth one is, due to the dissociation of product. This is mainly because of the electron collision process, which is responsible for the production of gaseous product as an output. And hence we are having the formation of small cavity, or you can say gas bubble, in case of liquid dielectric media. Now practically it was found that when a liquid dielectric media having some gas bubble, or you can say air cavity, and when this particular arrangement is subjected in the presence of very high electric potential, then there is a potential drop occur along the length of that particular gas bubble. And suppose if you are interested to calculate what will be the mathematical expression of electric field across that gas bubble, so that can be represented by equation number 1. So in this equation, epsilon 2 indicate the permittivity of liquid dielectric medium, and capital E suffix O indicate the electric field applied across a liquid dielectric medium in the absence of gas bubble. So the same thing is mentioned over here. Now, as the magnitude of applied electric field is increased, it was found that the gas bubble will try to elongate along its length, keeping the overall volume constant. This is one of the most important phenomena which is occurring over here. Now, due to this, what will happen? The voltage drop across the gas bubble also increases. And practically, it is found that if the magnitude of this voltage drop is more than Paschen's minimum voltage, then the breakdown mechanism is initiated. Now, what is the concept behind this? From the knowledge of our previous lecture, we know that in order to initiate the process of breakdown in case of any medium, it may be solid, it may be liquid, or it may be gas, we required some minimum input voltage. And if the value of applied voltage is more than that minimum input voltage, then we can say that the breakdown mechanism initiated. In the same way, in this case, practically it was found that when the magnitude of applied voltage increases, corresponding to the increase in magnitude of applied voltage, the potential drop across the gas bubble also increase. And if the value of that VB, which is nothing but the voltage drop across that gas bubble, is more than Paschen's minimum voltage, the breakdown mechanism is initiated. Hence, we can say that when the magnitude of voltage drop across gas bubble is more than the gas ionization potential of that particular medium, breakdown mechanism is initiated. Now, suppose if you are interested to write the most accurate mathematical expression of electric field across gas bubble, so it can be written by equation number 2. Now, from this equation, it is very clear that the value of EB, which is nothing but electric field across a gas bubble, depends on various parameters. For example, it depends on epsilon 1 and epsilon 2. where epsilon 1 indicate the permittivity of gas bubble and epsilon 2 indicate the permittivity of liquid medium. Then it also depends on small r, where small r indicate the radius of gas bubble. Then it depends on sigma, which is nothing but the surface tension of liquid medium. Then it also depends on Vb, where Vb indicate the voltage drop across gas bubble. So from equation 2, it is very clear that the breakdown strength depends on various parameters. So first one is, it depends on the surface tension of liquid indicated by symbol sigma. Then it depends on the permittivity of liquid and gas bubble, that is epsilon 2 and epsilon 1 respectively. Then it also depends on the initial radius of gas bubble indicated by symbol small r. Now we know that the radius of gas bubble depends on the temperature and pressure. So from this we conclude that the breakdown strength also depends on the initial temperature and pressure associated with a liquid dielectric medium, and it also depends on the voltage drop in case of gas bubble indicated by symbol capital V suffix small b. Now let us discuss what are the drawbacks of cavity breakdown mechanism. So the first drawback is, this theory does not account the production of initial gas bubble, because of which what will happen, the experimental value of breakdown strength is much less as compared to the calculated value. Second thing is that in this mechanism we assume that the gas bubble will try to elongate in its length, keeping the overall volume constant, but this is practical only in case of water bubble by applying the simple gas law, that is nothing but PV equals to RT. So in order to overcome the above problem, the modified expression of critical breakdown strength according to cavity breakdown mechanism is given by, let that equation number 3. Now in this equation, capital G and capital H are another unknown term, where capital G is indicated by this equation and capital H is indicated by this expression. Now in both the expression, beta is one of the most common factor, which is defined as the ratio of longer diameter to shorter diameter of spheroid. Now what is the concept of spheroid? In this case, as I told you that in the presence of applied electric field, what will happen? The water molecule, or you can say gas bubble, are trying to elongate along its length, keeping the overall volume constant. So their shape is trying to convert from sphere to a spheroid. So this indicate a pictorial view of spheroid, where this indicate the longer diameter and this indicate the shorter diameter. So the ratio of longer diameter to shorter diameter is indicated by symbol beta. So once you know the value of beta, you can calculate the value of G, you can calculate the value of H by knowing the value of permittivity of air bubble followed by liquid, by knowing the value of small r, by knowing the value of sigma, we can calculate the value of EC. Now practically it was found that under the influence of electric field, when the value of beta is around 1.85, this lead to instability in case of liquid dielectric medium. Now in this case, if you assume the remaining operating parameter, like if you take transformer oil where epsilon 2 is going to be equal to 2, the water bubble radius if you consider as 1 micrometer, if you consider sigma as 43 dyne per centimeter, and if you put all these parameters in equation number 3, you will get the value of critical electric field strength as 2 to 6 kV per centimeter. So this is what the basic philosophy behind cavity breakdown mechanism in case of liquid dielectric media. Now let us discuss the another topic from unit number 3, that is electroconvection breakdown mechanism. Now according to this theory, or you can say mechanism, a breakdown process is initiated due to the injection of charge carrier in a liquid dielectric media because of electrode surface. Now what will happen? These charge carrier are responsible for the formation of space charges in a liquid medium. Now practically it was found that these space charges, when they are placed in the presence of applied electric field, they will experience a force, you can say a Coulombic force, which results into a hydrodynamic instability in case of liquid medium. Now due to the interaction of these space charges with applied electric field, responsible for the formation of eddy motion in case of liquid dielectric medium. And when the magnitude of this applied voltage is nearer to the breakdown voltage of liquid medium, we can say that the speed of this eddy motion is given by this equation, where epsilon 2 indicate the permittivity of liquid medium and rho indicate the density of liquid medium. Now in this case, what will happen? These space charges, or you can say charge carrier, which are responsible for space charges formation, have some net ionic drift velocity, which is given by Vd equals to K into capital E, where capital K indicate the mobility of ions. Now according to this theory, the instability occur when the magnitude of this eddy motion, which is produced in that liquid dielectric media due to the interaction of those space charges in the presence of applied electric field, is more than ionic drift velocity. So mathematically we can write, when the magnitude of Ve is more than Vd, hydrodynamic instability occur in case of liquid dielectric media, which is responsible for its breakdown mechanism. Thank you.